So firstly, I had an amazing session. I hadn't thought that it will be such an enthralling experience. However, I have a couple of questions. My first question is that since I myself have PCOS and I've read extensively about it, and allopathy very clearly mentions that it does not have any cure.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to know what kind of impact does sound therapy have on PCOS and whether it's curable through sound therapy.
Surely, amazing question, and I'm glad that you had an amazing experience of this sound therapy. Now, sound therapy is a very limited English term. In Ayurvedic scripture or in the Sanskrit language, it is called as Nadi Yoga. And the sound therapy is very much based on the Ayurvedic medical system. Now in Ayurveda, we have the five great elements, the Panchamahabhut and the three dosh, the fundamentals of Ayurveda. And yes, sound therapy has a cure for PCOS, which goes in hand with Ayurveda. So it cures by balancing the three dosh, by balancing the three biological energetic humors. So yes, Ayurveda as well as the sound therapy has cure for PCOS and any kind of a reproductive ailments and disorders.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, like Ayurveda very clearly says that no matter how grave your condition is, when it comes to PCOS or any other reproductive disorders,
yes,
it does have a cure for PCOS, no matter how bad your situation is.
Mm-hmm.
So what you're trying to say is that this is in sync with Ayurveda, and that's how it's possible to cure PCOS.
Yes.
And have you experienced cases or witnessed people who have been able to take the journey and cure their PCOS?
Yes, very much. We have reported testimonials, documented since last 10 years. My Guruji, who has initiated the art of Nadi Yoga and sound therapy in India in a way. So we have documented results on stress to cancer actually.
Wow.
Cancer not completely cured but healed through the sound, through the Ayurvedic aspect. And we have seen reported testimonials on PCOS, reproductive issues and other deadly disorders which the Western medicine or the allopathic medicine says there is maybe not cure possible, but yes, we have seen the results through sound therapy only through sound therapy. And the miracle of sound therapy is it goes hand in hand with anything, even the Ayurveda, it goes hand in hand. It doesn't say you have to stop the other system and only do the Ayurvedic aspect or the sound.
Basically, there's no precaution that you have to take.
Yes.
You can do it with anything that you're continuing to do.
Yes, very much.
Okay. My next question is that how is sound therapy not, I mean, since it has such positive and long-lasting impacts on human bodies and their psychology, why is it not very known?
Yes.
And why isn't there awareness about it? Much as Ayurveda and allopathy.
Very good question. Now, this is actually a hidden secret. It's a secret, that's why it's hidden. And this has been kept a secret because once you understand the energetic or the spectrum of frequencies, you can actually do anything with it.
Okay.
So it's a hidden secret. It's a secret, and it has been explicitly mentioned in the Yogashika Upanishad, which says about the Nadi Yoga. Even in Ayurveda, it has been mentioned about how sound can be used for chikitsa. Then in the Jnaneshwari. Now Jnaneshwari is the first commentary or the first translation of Gita, which has been done by Santa Jnaneshwar, or many other people also named them as Santa Jnaneshwar. So now he has explicitly mentioned in Jnaneshwari how to use this singing bowls and how to use sound for overall health and well-being.
Right.
Not just for only physical or psychological benefits, but for spiritual growth. This is for spiritual growth. And the moment you are growing in your consciousness and awareness, you automatically understand the gist of your physical ailments. So it is the holistic approach towards anything. Maybe towards your health, your career, your finances, your relationships. So sound has impact on all these areas.
So
not only
answering the question, like basically it's a tool that can either make or break,
yes,
your vibe or your psyche.
Yes. Yes.
That's
why it's a tool. Yes, it's a tool. Yes, correct. And if it also depends on the person who is using. Now the person Now, this is very much a secret of Spanda Shastra. Now, Spanda Shastra is a scripture on divine vibrations. Now, what it says is, आप किसको सुन रहे हो आप उसके जैसे बनते हो the vibrations that you receive
is what you pick up
normally हमें लगता है कि हम जो food खाते उससे बनते हैं या जो information पढ़ते हैं उससे but it's not like that it's the vibrations that we receive
I think it's everything you consume including the vibration
yes.
and the food and the air everything
yes but the
so
main
major
thing,
part of it
yes.
is the vibration
major the most fundamental aspect and that is about it and If we go to the aspect that why this kind of ailments are now happening in youth, because the thing is, as per Ayurveda, there are three doshas, kapha, pitta, vata. Now PCOS or the reproductive disorders, they generally fall into the kapha disorder or the kapha imbalance. So the moment your kapha is imbalanced, your hormonal activities are imbalanced. So the necessary hormones for the reproductive cycle
mm-hmm.
is imbalanced and due to that, the movement, which is the vat, that also gets disturbed. And due to that, the kapha and the vat getting disturbed, the metabolic activities, which is the fire, which is the pitta, that is also getting disturbed. So the origin is for reproductive or PCOS is imbalanced of kapha. And how sound works is, it starts to balance all the three doshas. That's the magic. Not only on the physical layer, but also on the emotional layer. And also now, many of the diseases that we get is because of the overactive mind. We have this nervous system which connects the head, the heart and the navel.
Gut.
And the gut. Now if the connection right now what is happening is, we are always in the mind. Overthinking, stress, anxiety. And always in the analysis, always ये क्या है, वो क्या है, इतना पैसा कैसे है, so always in the overthinking. Now what happens because of that? The more you overthink, the more energy is upwards, only above the neck. So the vital organs and the vital systems down below, they are not getting the necessary balance of
attention.
The attention. Yes, very much. Energy flows where attention
goes.
Yeah. Very true. And that's why if you see right now, the entire youth, the entire generation is having issues with reproduction, is having issues with the reproductive aspects, the digestive aspects and the cardiovascular. So
this sound therapy basically helps you concentrate or channelize your energies throughout the body.
Yes, throughout the
Wherever
body.
Wherever there is an ailment,
yes.
you can concentrate it there
Correct.
And treat that. Okay.
Yes. So what it does is first it brings Trupti. Trupti means contentment. So first it balances the dosha, then it brings contentment and joy.
Mm-hmm.
And once your mind, which is always overactive, usko hume shant karna hai. And shant hoke uske beyond bhi jana hai. That's for later stage. But first we have to relax a bit. And the moment you are relaxed, you channelize the energies down below where it is necessary to the gut. And to the heart, and once that is balanced, all the issues of the kapha, the pitta, and the vata, they are solved. And now, generally, even many people ask questions that how many sessions are necessary. This is not a session-oriented thing. You can actually get the singing bowls. Singing bowls. That's the tool we are using in the market right now. It has been called as Tibetan singing bowls or Himalayan singing bowls. No one knows the origin as well. But
and
the origins,
basically use it to heal.
Yes, yes, yes. The origin is basically in the scriptures of Indians. And this is the tool which we can, individually people can do it. They can keep at our home. The vibrations of the home are also balanced.
They don't need anybody to
yes.
conduct it. They can do it themselves.
They can do it themselves. And that's the best thing actually. We say that no one is there to take attention. But actually you have yourself.
Great.
So the journey starts with the self. The moment you change your self vibrations, automatically the manifestations in all your areas are getting changed. Just say Mahatma Gandhi bolte hai, be the change if you want to see the change. So change your vibrations, elevate your vibrations, and then you can have holistic growth.
Thank you.
Yes.
Yeah. Thanks.